Promising news just out about a new vaccine trial for COVID-19, but what does that really mean at this stage?
Plus, a viewer asks about the safety of air travel, so we're going to ask the doc. That would be Dr. Anthony Cardillo, CEO of Mend Urgent Care and ER specialist. And I understand we get you actually in the ER today, which is pretty neat. Thanks for joining us today, doctor, and happy Memorial Day to you. Now, here's the first question. A company in China was among the first to start testing a COVID-19 vaccine in humans, and they just published their phase one results. What do the results look like, and what do you think about this?
Yeah, David, so this is a very promising study, obviously, coming out of Wuhan. They had a little bit of a head start, obviously. This is the first human trial study, phase one human trial, so that gives us a lot more data. And what they found in the Lancet publication was actually that out of the 1,000 patients that they had inoculated, a vast majority actually built an immune response. They actually made antibodies. And more importantly, they found that their T cells, the second part of our immune system, actually cleared the viral particles that were attacked by those antibodies. So a lot of promising results here. Again, still phase one. We have to roll out phase two and phase three clinical trials, test a lot more people. And the big question is going to be, does it confer immunity? Does this vaccine actually lead to, you know, destruction of this virus as we enter into the next season? We don't have that data yet. Only time will tell. But the original, these initial reports are highly promising, and really going to help us move forward.
Great. Well, more research news. This one from the New England Journal of Medicine report about remdesivir. It showed the drug was superior to a placebo in shortening the recovery time of adults hospitalized with COVID-19. Will that have any impact on making the drug available to more people?
Certainly, Ellen, it's going to push things forward for us. We know that in this study, we decreased the length of the disease from 15 days down to 11 days, which is very, very important for us. We know that our initial study reports came out that leaked out a little bit early, but now this verifies what the study was found to show, and it's very promising. We know that remdesivir is actually decreasing the duration. We're rolling this out to a lot of hospitals now. This will be the first go-to drug for treatment. Another part of this study was it showed that we should start treatment earlier as opposed to waiting for a person to be intubated. So we're going to see a lot of hospitals starting this treatment modality a little bit earlier and sooner to get a jump on things. Now, remember, this is still only an IV preparation, so we can't use it in the outpatient world like we have for influenza, for example, with Tamiflu. We're still hoping to have an outpatient medication that we can treat minor symptoms with, but this is for more seriously ill patients in the hospital.
All right, we're going to get to our viewer question tomorrow, but we appreciate your time. We know you're in the ER. We hope you have a quiet, peaceful time today. One of the few businesses where you want to be not busy.
Right.
Yeah.
Hello, I'm Mark Brown. Click the ABC7 logo to subscribe to our Eyewitness News YouTube channel.